Question number 5. Sum of the roots of the quadratic equation is double of their product. Find k if the equation is x square minus 4x plus k plus 3 is equal to 0. Once again, read the example carefully. Sum of the roots of the quadratic equation is, we know the sum of the roots of the quadratic equation, and that is equal to double of their product. Sum of the roots of the quadratic equation, that is alpha plus beta, is equal to double their product, 2 multiplied by alpha into beta. That is, alpha plus beta is equal to 2 into alpha beta. That is given information for this quadratic equation. Then find the value of k. So here we will write the quadratic equation first. Since the information is given about the sum of the roots of the quadratic equation and the product of the roots of the quadratic equation, we will write the given quadratic equation here. We will get the values of a, b and c first, and then we will use these values in the given equation, that is alpha plus beta is equal to 2 alpha beta. So we will write the quadratic equation first. X square minus 4kx plus k plus 3 is equal to 0. Now, the given quadratic equation is in the standard form, but many students have the problem whether this k is the part of this term or this term. That is very important thing. Now, since in this term only variable is there x, so this is the linear term, this is quadratic term, and remaining all part is constant term. This is square term, this is linear term, and the remaining all the part is constant term. Here we have to find the value of k, and k is constant since k is here, but we have variable also there, and here the power is 1, so we say it as, we call it as linear term, we call it as square term, and this remaining part is constant. So we will compare this equation with the standard form, and we will get the values of a, b and c. If you have question why we are getting the values of a, b and c, see the given information, sum of the roots of the quadratic equation is equal to double of their product, that is alpha plus beta is equal to 2 into alpha beta. Now, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b upon a. We know the relationship between the roots and the coefficients of the quadratic equation. That is, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b upon a, and alpha into beta is equal to c upon a. So we have to get the values of a, b and c, otherwise we cannot find the value of k. So we have to compare this equation with the standard form. Comparing with a x square plus b x plus c is equal to 0. Value of a, that is coefficient of square term, it is 1. Value of b, that is coefficient of x, and it is minus 4k. And the value of c, that is constant term, and it is k plus 3. Now, as we have given that sum of the roots is equal to double of their product, sum of the roots of the given quadratic equation, let alpha and beta be the roots of the given quadratic equation. We have given that alpha plus beta is equal to 2 into alpha beta. This is given information. This is given information. Sum of the roots of the quadratic equation is equal to the double of their product. And now put the values, alpha plus beta is minus b upon a. It is equal to 2 multiplied by alpha into beta is c upon a. And here a gets cancelled. Since we have only single term here, we have single term here, and both the numbers have same denominator. If we transfer this a to the right side, then a gets cancelled, or if you transfer this a to the left side, then again a gets cancelled. cancel. So directly we cancel these terms and we get minus b is equal to 2c. Now put the values. This minus remains as it is. Value of b is minus 4k. It is equal to 2 multiplied by value of c is k plus 3. Now calculate it, minus into minus plus, that is 4k is equal to 2 into k is 2k plus 2 into 3 is 6. Or simply you can transfer this 2 to the left side also. Calculation gets less. So you can do like that. So we have multiplied already there. So we will take calculations. 4k and this 2k will transfer to the left side. 4k minus 2k is equal to 6. And this is 2k is equal to 6. So k is equal to 6 upon 2 and k is equal to 3. Therefore, value of k is 3. Question number 6. Alpha and beta are the roots of the quadratic equation y square minus 2y minus 7 is equal to 0. Find alpha square plus beta square. And number 2, alpha cube plus beta cube. We have to find the two values. First value, alpha square plus beta square. And the second value, alpha cube plus beta cube. So we will write the first quadratic equation which we have given. That is y square minus 2y minus 7 is equal to 0. Since we have to get the value of alpha square plus beta square. Since we have to get the value of alpha square plus beta square, we will think about the expansion formula of the square of the two terms, that is a plus b bracket square. Simply you can write alpha plus beta bracket square. And that expansion is alpha plus beta bracket square is equal to alpha square plus beta square plus 2 alpha beta. Means we need to find alpha plus beta and alpha into beta first from this equation. We have to find the values of alpha plus beta, that is sum of the roots and the product of the root. And then we have to find these values. If you want to find these values directly, that is not possible to find these values directly. We have to get alpha plus beta and alpha into beta first, that is sum of the roots of the given quadratic equation and product of the roots of the given quadratic equation. So we will compare this quadratic equation with the standard form. Comparing with ay square plus by plus c is equal to 0 or ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. We have a is equal to 1. We have b is equal to minus 2 and c is equal to minus 7. So first we will find alpha plus beta, that is equal to, and we know the relation, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b upon a. Put the values there, this minus sign as it is. Value of b is minus 2 divided by a is 1, and no need to write 1 in the denominator. It's minus minus plus, and we get alpha plus beta is equal to 2. Now we have to find the value of alpha into beta. So we will get that value, alpha into beta is equal to c upon a. The value of c is minus 7 upon a is 1. No need to write the 1 in the denominator. So we have minus 7 only. Sum of the roots is 2 and the product of the roots is minus 7. Now, as we have to find the value of alpha square plus beta square, we have identity that directly you can write alpha square plus beta square is equal to alpha plus beta bracket square minus 2 alpha beta. It is an identity. We will write alpha square plus beta square is equal to alpha plus beta bracket square minus 2 alpha beta. It is an identity. But many students didn't know this identity. Actually, you knows the identity. Just if we shift this term to the left side, minus 2 alpha beta to the left side, it is square expansion of the sum of the two terms. Or directly you can write here the square expansion of sum of the two terms alpha plus beta bracket square. This identity everyone knows since the 7th standard. We use this identity, that is a plus b bracket square is equal to a square plus b square plus twice ab. So here just we have in place of a and b alpha and beta. So we can write it as alpha square plus beta square plus 2 alpha beta. Now we have to put the value, since we have to find this value alpha square plus beta square, we have to find, and other values we know, we know alpha plus beta, it is 2, we know alpha into beta, it is minus 7, and this part we have to find alpha square plus beta square. So we will put it as it is, alpha square plus beta square, and we will transfer this to alpha beta to the left side. No need to transfer also. Put the values first, we write the identity. Why we use the sum of the two terms identity there, square expansion of sum of the two terms? Because we have to find alpha square plus beta square. See, we have squares in the both the terms, so we use square expansion. Now here we have to find alpha cube plus beta cube, so definitely we will use the cubic identity there, alpha plus beta bracket cube, and putting the values in that identity we will get the value of alpha cube plus beta cube. Here we have square terms, so we use the square expansion of sum of the two terms. Some students may be asking that why not we are using here alpha minus beta bracket square, because we didn't know alpha minus beta. We know alpha plus beta, but we didn't know the alpha minus beta. So we are not using that identity. If we use that identity, alpha minus beta bracket square is equal to, you will get alpha square plus beta square minus 2 alpha beta, but we didn't know alpha minus beta. So we have to use this identity only, alpha plus beta bracket square is equal to alpha square plus beta square plus 2 alpha beta. Put the values there, alpha plus beta is 2, so we write 2 here, square of it, it is equal to alpha square plus beta square as it is, because we have to find the value of that expression, plus 2 multiplied by alpha into beta is minus 7. Now calculate it, 2 square is 4. This alpha square plus beta square as it is, because we have to find the value of it, plus into minus minus 2 multiplied by 7 is 14. Now transfer this minus 14 to the left side, and now you will get the value of alpha square plus beta square, and it is 4 plus 14, that is 18. This is 4 plus 14, it is equal to alpha square plus beta square, and we get alpha square plus beta square is equal to 18. That is the answer of the first question, alpha square plus beta square, and it is 18. And now we have to get the value of alpha cube plus beta cube. So definitely we have to use the identity of alpha plus beta bracket cube. So here we can write the identity, alpha plus beta bracket cube, that is equal to alpha cube plus beta cube plus 3 alpha beta into the bracket alpha plus beta. It is an identity. Since 8th standard we are using this identity, a plus b bracket cube is equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into bracket a plus b. Just we have to write this identity in the form of alpha and beta. So we use alpha and beta there, alpha plus beta bracket cube is equal to alpha cube plus beta cube plus 3 alpha beta into bracket alpha plus beta. And now we have to put the values which we knows, the values which we knows, only two values we knows, alpha plus beta and alpha into beta. And this is the third one, alpha square plus beta square, but square terms are not there. So you have to use these two values only. Alpha plus beta is, see, we have to find this value alpha cube plus beta cube, and other all values we knows, just we didn't know alpha cube plus beta cube, that is we have to find, and other all the values we knows. So we will put the remaining values there, alpha plus beta is 2, so we have 2 cube here, it is equal to, we have to find alpha cube plus beta cube, so alpha cube plus beta cube remains as it is, 3 multiplied by alpha into beta is minus 7, bracket close, multiplication. Alpha plus beta is again 2. Now calculate it. 2 cube is 8. This alpha cube plus beta cube as it is. Plus into minus, minus, minus into plus, minus. 3 into 7, 21, 21 into 2, 42. Or 2 into 7, 14, 14, 3 is 42. Now transfer this minus 42 to the left side. So directly you will get the value of alpha cube plus beta cube. And we have 8 plus 42, it is equal to alpha cube plus beta cube. And here we get the value of alpha cube plus beta cube. And it is 50. 42 plus 8, it is 50. So this is all about the sixth question. And it is different example, different question. It is depend upon the relationship between the roots and the coefficients of the quadratic equation. But we have to use the identities. This identity and this identity, both the identities are very important. And we write in the simplest form. Just we write the square expansion of two terms. Just we write the cubic expansion of the two terms, sum of the two terms. And we get the values which we have to find, that is alpha square plus beta square and alpha cube plus beta cube. We will take the seventh question. Roots of each of the following quadratic equation are real and equal. Find the value of k. You have given a quadratic equation and it is also given that the roots of this quadratic equation are real and equal. Means definitely the value of discriminant is 0. That is b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. And this is all. We can put the values of a, b, c there and we will get the value of k. Here also same thing. We have given the quadratic equations and see the given information. The roots of the given quadratic equation are real and equal. Now just we have to think that when the roots of the given quadratic equation are real and equal. And it is if and only if b square minus 4ac, that is delta, is equal to 0. Then only the roots of the given quadratic equation are real and equal. So here it is indirectly it is given that delta is equal to 0. And putting values there, we have to get the value of k. So first we will write the given equation in standard form. See the given equation which is not into the standard form. So we will multiply this x by kx, kx into x, that is kx square, minus kx multiplied by 2, that is 2kx plus 6 as it is equal to 0. And now the given equation is into the standard form, comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. We have a is equal to k, we have b is equal to minus 2k, and we have c is equal to 6. As we have given that the roots of the given quadratic equation are real and equal. Roots of given quadratic equation. Roots of given quadratic equation are real and equal. Are real and equal. That is given information. Therefore, we can write b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. Now put the values there. Value of b is minus 2k, square of it minus 4 multiplied by value of a is k, value of c is 6, that is equals to 0. Square of any negative number is always positive. So we have 4k square minus 6 4s are 24k, it is equal to 0. You can take 4k as common. We have 4 here, we have 24 here. 24 is divisible by 4. So 4 will be taken common, and here we have k square, we have k here, k is also taken common. So we have 4k as common. From these two terms, we take 4k as common. Now what is remaining inside the bracket? That is k minus 6, it is equal to 0. What is remaining inside the bracket? Out of 4k square, 4k is taken common, so k is remaining. Minus out of 24k, 4k is taken common, so 6 is remaining only. Now product of these two terms is 0. product of these two terms 4k and k minus 6 is 0. So we can write 4k is equal to 0, or we can write k minus 6 is equal to 0. So we have k is equal to 0 divided by 4, or k is equal to 0 plus 6, that is 6, and here 0 divided by 4, that is 0. So we get two values of k. K is equal to 0 or k is equal to 6. But see, k is the coefficient of square term. So we cannot use k is equal to 0. Since the k is coefficient of square term, we get two values, but one value is correct and one value is incorrect. Why? Because k is the coefficient of square term, and if we take 0 in place of k, then it is not the quadratic equation. Square term becomes 0. So we cannot take k is equal to 0. So here you can write k is equal to 0, k is not equal to 0, or you can write k is equal to 0 not satisfies the given quadratic equation. K is equal to 0 not satisfies. Given quadratic equation. Therefore, k is not equal to 0. So we have k is equal to 6 only. Therefore, the value of k is, the value of k is 6. That is not 0. We get 0, but 0 not satisfies the given quadratic equation. So we have k is equal to 6 only. Now see the second example. In the second question, in the second example, we have given a quadratic equation, that is 3y square plus ky plus 12 is equal to 0, and we have to find the value of k. 3y square plus ky plus 12 is equal to 0. Now the given equation is already in the standard form. So we will get the values of a, b, c comparing with standard form. Comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. We have a is equal to 3, b is equal to k, and c is equal to 12. As we have given that the roots are real and equal. Roots are real and equal. So we can write b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, or you can write delta is equal to 0. Now put the values. Value of b is k, square of it minus 4 into 3 into 12, that is equal to 0. This is k square minus 4, 3 is 12, 12 into 12 is 144, is equal to 0. You can transfer 144 to the right side. K square is equal to 144. Taking square root of both the sides, k is equal to plus or minus 12. K is equal to positive 12, or k is equal to negative 12. And here both the values are appropriate. Both the values are correct. We can use both the values. Here k is not the 0. So we can use both the values, and if k is equal to 0 we get in this equation, then only you can use k is equal to 0, because k is not the coefficient of square term. Here in the previous example, k is the coefficient of square term. Since we not use the value of k 0, here we will use both the values. So you can write the answer into the words, values of k are 12 and minus 12. So this is all about the practice set 2.5. We simplify each and every question. Thank you.